Hello. So today we're talking about sequential circuits. So last time you remember that we talked about what a circuit was and how we build circuits from underlying components. And we focused mainly on combinational circuits. So today we're going to talk about sequential circuits. And the primary motivation here is that we want a circuit that can remember something, because we can do computation now with combinational circuits, but we haven't seen any way of implementing memory yet. And so we want some way of making a circuit remember something. So it's worth pausing at this point and thinking about this a little bit, and perhaps maybe sketch out an idea of what this might look like in a circuit. Maybe you can try to draw a circuit that remembers its previous output value. So if you think about this a little bit, the core concept that you need in order to implement this is a loopback. So some way of taking the output of the circuit and making it an input to the circuit. Once you've done this, you've created something called a storage circuit, or sometimes we call this a latch. And the key thing is that the truth table has to include previous state. Another way of thinking about these circuits and analyzing them is using something called a timing diagram. And this shows how the signals change with respect to time. So as events happen, what happens to the signals? So given inputs, can we determine outputs if some of those inputs are outputs from previous iterations? Okay, so here's a very simple latch in order to demonstrate these concepts. So there is a NOT, an OR, and an AND, and then two inputs called S and R, which we're told stand for set and reset. And then our timing diagram is going to be over here, and we're going to think about what happens to the circuit as various events happen. One thing you'll note here at the beginning is that there are some lines here that are red. These are lines where we don't know the output. So in this OR, we don't know the output because we know that this is a zero, but we don't know what this is, so we don't know what this output is here. And because we don't know what this output is, we don't know what the output of the AND is. And because we don't know what the output of the AND is, we don't know the value of this loopback branch. So in Logisim, this is indicated using the color red. In our timing diagram, we'll just not include a line for something that we don't know. Okay, so the first question is this. What happens if we turn on the S signal? So pause for a second and see if you can predict what's going to happen. Okay, so if we turn the S signal on over here, the effect that that's going to have is that now we know the output of the OR, because it doesn't matter what this value is anymore. As long as one of the inputs is 1, the output is going to be 1. So that's what happens. So this signal becomes a 1. Once that signal is a 1, both of the inputs to the AND are 1s, and now we have a 1 output. And so that means that now we know that the Q is on. So this, we draw the bar here kind of at the top of the range for Q. If Q had been off, we would have drawn the bar down here. You can see that S has now turned on. So we've gone from a low value to a high value. And this 1 here now propagates back around to here. And it's important to think about that for a second just to make sure that that doesn't change anything else. But of course it wouldn't actually, because we're already getting a 1 out of this OR. So turning the other thing on just means that now we know everything for sure, but it doesn't change the output. All right, so now I'm going to pause again and think about what would happen if now we turn S off. Okay, so if we turn S off, not a lot happens, because in this OR, we've got the previous value coming in as a 1, the previous value of Q, and so that leaves the output of the OR being 1, even if the other input of the OR gets set back to 0. So that's what happens here. And in the diagram, we show this by having S turn off, but all the other values remain the same. Okay, so you know what's coming next. So pause the video and think about what would happen in both the timing diagram and in the circuit if we turn on the R signal. All right, so if we turn on the R signal, that's going to turn this signal on here. The NOT is going to flip, and now we're going to get a 0 coming into this AND, which means that now the AND is producing a 0, because anything ANDed with 0 is going to be 0, which changes Q to a 0 and makes the 0 propagate through here, which means that the OR now turns off as well. So this is what it's going to look like in the circuit, and this is what has happened in the diagram. So R has turned on and Q has turned off. Okay, so the last bit then is what happens when we turn R off. So pause the video and see if you can predict what's going to happen then. All right, so hopefully you can see that when R turns off, that's going to turn this signal on, but since we're still getting the zero from the previous output of Q, then nothing else is going to change. All right, we could also represent this information using a truth table. So this is our new truth table, and you'll notice that the truth table requires a column for the old value of Q, which is sort of an input to the circuit, right? Because we've got the loopback edge here. And I'm not going to look at every single entry in this table, but you should look through it and convince yourself that this is what's going on. Generally speaking, the new value of Q is the same as the old value of Q. And that means that Q is in some sense remembering its old value. There are, of course, a couple of exceptions. So the first exception is here, where the zero, where the one changes to a zero. And that's when the R input is set. So that's the reset. So it's resetting from 1 to 0. And of course the opposite, where we have the S bit on, where we're now changing Q from 0 to a 1. A couple other things to note here is that there is also this interesting situation where S and R are both on. And in this particular circuit, we can see, if you were to work this out, you would see that in this case, the R kind of overrides the S, because if they're both on, if it's a zero, it stays zero, but if it's a one, it gets changed to a zero. So in this particular case, that's what happens when they're both the same. And then in the next video, we'll examine a more complicated latch.